Quiet.
Let's get right down to it. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw.
Not yet.
And this one hauled in by Tavon Austin. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll look to throw now on first down. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete.
Dan about tuning in to the stream, or should I just shut the fuck right down?
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And now he'll tuck it and run. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard.
Playing right now with quarterback Brett Favre.
And now they're in the hurry up. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw.
You got 86 overall Brett Favre here I'm playing with right now.
It's incomplete. The intended receiver, Tavon Austin. And it's third and short.
Playing with 86 overall Brett Favre right now, three versions.
He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
If you want to see him in action, want to see your gunslinger back in action, here's your chance.
And it's caught. Touchdown.
Hey, just hit a touchdown pass to Randy Moss. Favre to Moss.
And his guys are able to make this a close game again. The fly route works for the TD grab.
And you know the receivers.
Yeah, it all comes down to next week. Packers at Lions. Winner goes to the Super Bowl. Losers out of the playoffs.
All the way into the end zone. And then he was on the business end catching it once he got over the stripe.
So the drive there took 6 plays.
Yeah, she's a big one. Yeah, you want to come down for it? We'll watch it together.
They send this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone.
I think it's next Sunday, I believe.
A touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time.
No,
see if
it's
they can
Sunday.
Get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now.
Second down following the incompletion.
I said 10 games in a row and they'll be Super Bowl champs, and you kind of giggled at me, but now that's 5 in a row now. 5 more to go.
And brings up third down.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. Here's Dalton.
Yep.
And that's incomplete. His big tight end, Tyler Eifert, the intended receiver, and it's fourth down. Here's Kevin Huber now, as he'll kick it away for the second time.
You ain't tuned into the stream right now, you're missing out.
And now a low liner. I think he mishit him. Not good at all. Punted just 24 yards there. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. And now back out comes the offense. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset because they scored the last time.
Gonna lie, Red. I ain't too happy about the fact that you didn't claim one of these pops.
They were ready.
I ain't too happy about it at all.
May not have done that, but they certainly have played that way. The fourth quarter has belonged to them.
That's what I mean. I told you that, you know. But I mean, I ain't happy about that, you know.
They certainly made quick.
Love to, like, you know, more than like anything, I'd love to see you have a dog up at your house, man. I'd love to see that. More than anything, that's what I'd love to see, but, you know.
And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. The Bengal offense now gets set to head back out onto the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. But they're looking for it now.
Drop him, and it'll be a loss of about eight. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
Caught right side, Tate. That wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. They get the completed pass, but still.
You want tuning into the stream, or...
Third down, a shot here for Dolan. And the third down pass falls incomplete. Brandon Tate was the intended receiver. Now fourth down. Here's Kevin Huber now. As he's on to punt for Cincinnati.
Going in on Christmas Eve, huh?
In route dropped, as we just saw in that play.
Well, be watching the skies. You might see old Santi and the reindeer come over if you're going to be working throughout the night.
As opposed to being away from it and maybe having a little bit more space.
Oh, that's tonight, all right.
21 yards. Well done on the return. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over.
Yeah, he comes tonight, all right. He's going to be flying through the area with the reindeer, so watch your dick because you might just hear him.
And following that long touchdown pass, a one-point drive last time, you see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you.
That's tonight, man. It's tonight.
Not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
Again, it's Tomlinson. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Now Tomlinson on first and 10. Looking to find a lane, but he can't rein in at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're like him keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take. There's a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And a nickel look here for the Bengals as they try to defend this on third. And he'll fall forward to the 29-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. Made his first. This now from 36 yards away. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They come out 5 wide. 3 of them to the right side. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Jackson's got it over the middle. 11 yards for number 11.
Pre-game, when we were talking to him on the field, and he took his gloves off and showed us his fingers, a few misshapen ones in there, and now we know why, trying to catch those types of bullets.
That was a dart, yeah, even for a talented receiver. Those are tough to hang on to. One final kneel down here as it comes inside the 42nd mark, and that should be enough to put this one on ice. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. And that does it for this one. Pat yourself on the back. You just completed and dominated the Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge.
Mmm.
And you saw the challenge on the screen. I don't need to repeat it. It's solo challenge. Madden Ultimate Team. Go earn your keep. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Back to throw. Going for the deep ball. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And touchdown. DeSean Jackson, 65 yards. And this offense is running away with this one. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here comes the defense heading back out here on the road. They struggled that last drive. They were kind of hit two ways, both with the run and the pass.
And I love how you brought hit into it, because a lot of defense coordinators like to show a little cut-up film the night before a game. They usually have some boxing in there. It always shows the guy being the aggressor, the guy on his toes punching, not back on his heels taking punches. And that's what this defense was in the last possession.
They were on their heels. Will they be on their heels again? Let's see. First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. That's 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players and somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. We get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And on second and 10 now. Has in store for third. Third and long, it's Stafford. And that is incomplete. He was looking for Theo Riddick there. And fourth down coming up.
Well, no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
And Sanders now to return. Nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And possession will switch here as this offense will come on deep in their own territory. And here now the offense heading back out there. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. They'll look to throw here on first down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. A gain of six there on first. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Back to throw now on first down. And this one hauled in by Tavon Austin. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Here we go.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. Before he's out of bounds.
7 yards on the play, and that'll make it second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
They'll set up a throw, and he checks this one down to LT out of the backfield. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll bring up a third and one. And quickly, they get to the line. They'll look to throw for it on third and one. Drops this off to Tomlinson, complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Shotgun. He'll look to throw. And it's caught. Touchdown. Dez Bryant there to make the grab. And this offense continues to pour it on. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball out of the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
The risk-reward of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play, and here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them. And field position leads you to that type of play calling, and whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things, now they're giving up that type of field position, the advantage is switched to them.
Give them 18 on that one, and it's good enough for a Detroit first down. Riddick with a carry. That's some space here. Oh, nice spin. And he takes this one in.
The offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with it?
I would think that they would because if they were.
DeSean Jackson off to the races. Touchdown! DeSean. All right, nice job. I believe that is challenge met and defeated from where I sit. Congratulations. Good job on this Madden Ultimate Team solo challenge. Your challenge awaits. Can you fulfill that solo challenge? Time to find out. It is indeed the solo challenge, and it's Madden Ultimate Team time. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. does it put this one in the books. A successful Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. See you next time. So the challenge is laid out in front of you. Can you complete it? We're about to find out. Solo challenge, Madden Ultimate Team time. Let's go. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end.
Executed post draft.
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
And the Bears hands team able to pounce on it and get the football. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it. It was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that, just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics would tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers.
All about the numbers.
A good start.
A start that was sorely needed because this team looked like they might be out of this one, but getting a touchdown, getting back into it, gives them hope as they move forward.
Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite, but in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed, near the goal line, on a two-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field, so it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
Now this offense ready to take over again, and they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last time when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy.
It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown! DeSean Jackson with now his second touchdown of his third quarter. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. And the Bears hands team able to pounce on it and get the football. The Bears offense now gets set to still down here.
When you're playing catch up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but when they do have to look for them, they did score the lead.
Bears cut into that lead. So they've had two drives, and he's had the two receiving touchdowns.
And how about a game plan where you decide to force feed or feature someone, and it works?
First two drives, as you noted, end up in touchdown passes. I think they're going to keep going to him until defense makes any kind of an adjustment.
This will be fielded at the 8. And a big-time mess on the return. He's out of bounds. He won't even get this back to the 5-yard line.
Exactly a banner return, so he doesn't give his offense a whole lot of room to work with. They've got to go a long way down to try and score some points. I do know this from experience. There will be a few comments muttered his way by the offense as they head out on the field.
And he's able to get this up just shy of the 15. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now.
You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secures it.
Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. He's going to air one out. And that's caught inside the 35.
That I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like when you fit that in.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you're talking about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves.
It's an Alshon Jeffrey. Touchdown, Chicago. Alshon Jeffrey, 43 yards. And the Bears get a bit closer. And on that one, able to catch it. Also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
This will be fielded at the 8. And he's going to go out of bounds on the return. He won't even get this thing back to the 10-yard line. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Back to throw. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Completed pass on 2nd down. Now it's 3rd down as the defense looks for the stop. He'll look to throw here. And able to find Garcon. And he's going to have the 1st down yardage as he's down in about
pre-game warm-up, but I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. 1st down.
And they built that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Now back to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. A gain of 6 there on 1st. 4 yards remaining now on 2nd down.
Oh, let's go left.
throw again. He'll hit Jackson complete. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. They're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll look to throw now on first down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Back to throw again. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. They'll look to throw here on first down. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. Give him a couple on the catch at 2nd and 8. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Jackson's got it over the middle. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. He'll look to throw. Over the middle to Garcon. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down. Jim Caldwell is showing a little confidence in the offense. Leading them out there here on 4th down. It's a gain of 5 on the play. And on 4th down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. And now they're in the hurry up. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Bringing it in, Jackson left side. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. They'll look to throw again. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Back now at Soldier Field. As we're about ready to rock and roll for the 4th and final quarter.
Looks like a nickel set here defensively on 3rd and 2.
Yeah, maybe expecting a throw. Now back to throw. He completes it to Bryan. And he gets the 1st down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. Underneath, this is Bernard, and he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it 2nd and goal.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Long drive, the defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. Time running out here on the play clock. Quarterback sneak, hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
In today's NFL, most teams don't have as many goals for the game like we used to have where you checked off your boxes. But 0 turnovers, that's a universal. And while it won't likely cost them in this game, they're going to regret the fact that they caught 1 up here.
Yeah, their first blemish. They had mistake-free football prior. And now the Bears coming out as they get ready. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get
in trouble? The ball's out. It's in the end zone loose. And what else could go wrong at this point? This is going to be a defensive touchdown as they keep piling it on. That's something you have to be wary of on your side of the field, that close to the goal line. The defense, they are looking for that football. They got it. They scored it.
You are so right, and the quarterback has to speed things up himself. So close to the goal line, they're going to get after you. Make sure you get rid of the football and in a safe place.
Oh, a little cruel here. They're going to go for the onside kick up big. And the Bears hands team able to pounce on it and get the football. Now, 4th quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical. And coaches always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. Half that what he did after the catch.
Yeah, get your tight end. Let him get some land.
People like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Cutler to Langford on the draw. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. So they go out of the gun, trying to delay it on the draw, but nothing there.
Yeah, good play by the defense there. They sniffed it out and made sure there were no gaps for him to run. If you're the offense, though, you have to think to yourself, maybe I go play action down the field.
On second down, Cutler checks it underneath to Langford. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. A gain of 4 on the play, and that'll lead here to a third down.
I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. Throwing now, Cutler on first down, and he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help.
Looks for White, but it's intercepted. Brian Dawkins, the safety, with a pick.
Well, you're trailing, it's the fourth quarter, and you've got to throw the football. But the defense knows this, too. So they're just going to sit back, bring in an extra defensive back or two, the old nickel or dime strategy, Brandon, and wait for you to put that bad boy up for grabs. And this one winds up being intercepted.
Game in hand, the offense takes the knee. Victory very much in sight now as they'll take a knee. Down to a knee one more time. Nice job. Congratulations. Defeating the Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge.
All right, the challenge is in front of you. Do you accept it? I hope so. Keep the game on. Play the challenge. It's solo challenge, Madden Ultimate Team. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's got time. Trying to lay one up deep. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. 10 yards still left on second down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Second down. He's got time in the pocket. And some room to maneuver. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. They'll look to throw now on first down. Finding time. Looking deep downfield. Got a man that's caught at the 6-yard line. And he will take it in for the touchdown. A big play there. 61 yards. And his guys are able to strike for 6. All right, now a big 2-point conversion attempt still to come. Tomlinson. And he is into the end zone. The conversion attempt is good.
Hey, gamer girl.
That'll give him an 8-point lead here in the fourth. And boy, figure this one out. Leading here in the fourth. And now they're going to try an onside kick. And the Bears hands team able to pounce on it and get the football. And now Chicago getting ready to go.
Yeah, I'm doing all right.
And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. But pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
This will be caught inside the 10. Touchdown, Chicago! Alshon Jeffrey, 38 yards. And now the Bears are within a 2-point conversion of tying up the game. Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches, and we've had quoted back to us.
And he's going to be sacked. They came after him. He couldn't get away. And this remains a 2-point game. And the failure to convert and tie the game, now the pressure shifts back to the defense.
But I think it was the right play. I think it was the right call to try and tie the game there. Kick an extra point, you're still down one. What's the sense? I like what they did.
We focus our attention on the Bears' defense now. Now, they gave up a touchdown last drive. You kind of need to hit the reset button after every touchdown and give it up, Charles.
I love that. And the way that you phrased it is perfect.
Pressure comes right, and he goes down hard, flat on his back. Akeem Hicks in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. This one just shy of midfield, all the way to the 49. And quickly, they get to the line. They'll look to throw here on first down. He's got time. Now he'll escape to his left. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll be second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He sets to fire deep. And it's caught. Touchdown. Deshaun Jackson, 42 yards. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. And the defensive there, that was a battle. He just made a really nice play.
A really nice play, making sure his body position was correct. And how about the throw? Zipped it in there.
And it results in the touchdown. And up two scores late. No clue why you do this here, but they're going to go for the onside kick. Oh, did the kicking team get it? Yes. The onside kick works like a charm. Well, they just scored. They got the lead, and they decide to keep their foot on the accelerator, so to speak.
Scouting, scouting, scouting. They had to have seen something in their preparation for this game that told them in this situation, if they get the look they like, let's go ahead and go for it anyway. They like being bold.
23 yards on the play. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On first down, he'll drop to throw. 7-yard line, the catch is made. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10 to the 7. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And incomplete, he dropped it in the end zone.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it in the end zone. A big time drop.
Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Dez Bryant, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense, but in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Got it?
And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Herman Moore from 6 yards away. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
And now a whistle and a timeout called by the kicking team. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And the Bears hands team able to pounce on it and get the football. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. On first and 10, it's Cutler. Jeffrey with a catch outside. He has his two scores, but still a sizable deficit in this game.
Do you have him in fantasy football this week?
Unfortunately, no.
It's too bad, right? That would have been big points, but he is really trying to rally his team.
And now the pressure gets there, and he goes down. So he couldn't get rid of the football, and that deficit stays right where it is. Down two scores, out of timeouts. They must recover if they're going to have any shot. Unit ready to see what they can do here, and they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you score once, you feel like you can come back out there and get it done again. No matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. Here we go. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. That is caught at the 7. Get him down, but he does reach the 5. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Akeem Hicks in there to take him down and to take us to the 2-minute warning. So it's our visitors with a football as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they look to solve this one away. Back to throw now. And it's caught. Touchdown. DeSean Jackson with now two fourth quarter touchdowns. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside in 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
And the Bears' hands team able to pounce on it and get the football. Now the Bears' offense ready to take over again. They're down big here late.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge. It's always a coach when you want to call. You just wave the hand like, who cares? Let's get out of here. And you do something some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better.
Yeah.
As they continue to move forward.
Yeah, finish one. Put this one behind them. It's brought in by Jeffrey. Touchdown, Chicago. Alshon Jeffrey finishing strong.
And that touchdown puts us in a position to have a discussion, doesn't it? Now, it'll be a two-score game after the conversion.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt with a two-score game, they're going to have to onside kick it. We'll just see if they've got a miracle up their sleeve.
And you wonder what onside kicks they're going to use and in what sequence if they hope to have a chance to win this game.
Well, that certainly makes things more interesting. You get the score, then you get the onside kick. A little uphill battle still, but a start.
It's not mission accomplished, but the plan is working. They are in a great spot right now. And the best part, they put the defense right back out on the field after having already scored.
Yeah, they've got the momentum here now. Fourth quarter of play. On second down, Langford. And he is going to lose yardage here. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. There's Cutler. It's caught. Eddie Royal. The 20. 10. Touchdown, Chicago. Eddie Royal. 69 yards. And the Bears draw a bit closer.
And they put it in the end zone, which was job one. Now they have to convert. And then it's decision time, isn't it?
Yeah, this is what all teams go through. You look at the clock. You're inside 2 minutes. Look at your timeouts. Make that onside kick decision.
Yeah, how do you feel about your defense, where you are in terms of the scoreboard, and the time left on the clock, as you noted? So many things to go through.
They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though. Now this one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it in.
Jackson's got it over the middle. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. They're going to hurry back to the line now. It's a gain of 7, and it'll be a second down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Forced out to his left, and he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Out of the gun. Solo.
challenge. You did it. You defeated it. Congratulations. We'll see you next time.
Fucking fire back, baby. Give me that fucking fire back.
All right, it's Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. You know the drill. Let's get right down to it. They come out five wide, five to the right side. Back to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a four or so. Near the 45, they'll spot it at the 44.
Quiet.
That one first down. He'll drop to throw it. He's going to loft one deep left side here. That's caught inside the 20. And a huge play that time. And he hit 40 yards. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Can't pin that one on the quarterback, Charles. The O-line, they've got to protect
them. And they know it. That's their meal ticket. They want to take care of the big guy behind them. In this case, they let him down.
Now we'll look to throw here on second and 10. Man, that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. When a guy hops in the air, airborne to try to knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab them. That'll be a holding penalty. So all they're trying to do is make some type of a play on it, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
And it's caught. Touchdown. Deshaun. And that does it for this one. Pat yourself on the back. You just completed and dominated the Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge.
You saw the challenge on the screen. I don't need to repeat it. It's solo challenge. Madden Ultimate Team. Go earn your keep. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. They'll drop the throw. He's got time in the pocket. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. 10 yards on the pickup there. And that'll give him a first down. they'll look to throw. Going up top. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on and it's second down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
And this one hauled in by Tavon Austin. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. Back to throw now on first down. Bringing it in, Jackson left side. And he's into the end zone for the receiving touchdown. Deshaun Jackson, 43 yards. And his guys are able to strike for six. And a nice job by him to catch the slant and then navigate the break free.
And receivers love slant routes because it gets the ball in their hands so quickly and oftentimes on the move. And when they're on the move like that, then they get to use their best asset, which is usually their speed.
And their speed sometimes, like this instance, can take them into the end zone. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Patriot offense now set to come back out on the field. On first and 10, here's Brady. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. They dial up the corner blitz that time, and it delivers to the tune of a 9-yard loss.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
That throw good for only a couple and brings up third down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Play action. Now it's Brady. Finding time. And he's going to be grabbed and pulled down.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there. That's exactly what happened on that play.
Stopping
when they're not going to stop you. Take it all the way in.
So after surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the defense now here back onto the field. They sure didn't get a whole lot of rest. They had the three and out forced a punt, but that's returned for a touchdown, so they're on the field quickly.
So they're cheering. They're happy. They like what they saw.
They're like, oh, I got to go get my helmet.
But it is a quick turnaround, so we'll see how they handle that on this possession.
Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And he's able to get this one up to the 45-yard line. And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the two-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the two-minute signal.
A reminder coming up at halftime while the two of us head for warmer areas of the press box. We'll be sending you to Orlando where Larry Ridley will have highlights and analysis of this first half.
Send me to Orlando, please.
Don't be so soft. Call it a gain of three, and it'll bring up a second down.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. It was a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ike's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility over the toe tap.
No doubt about it. Ike doing the balance.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. It'll go as a loss of about six, and now it brings up third. And they're going to speed things up here. On third and long, it's Brady. And he dumps it off to Blunt. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield. called by the defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. 35 yards that time on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. And he's been good. Two first half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead, and they feel really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going
to
say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
Back to throw now on second and 10.
Statistician Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this, or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to.
All right, nice job. I believe that is challenge met and defeated from where I sit. Congratulations. Good job on this Madden Ultimate Team solo challenge. Your challenge awaits. Can you fulfill that solo challenge? Time to find out. It is indeed the solo challenge, and it's Madden Ultimate Team time. They'll look to throw. Solid gain of 27. And now they're in the hurry up. Back to throw. And this one hauled in by Tavon Austin. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. It goes as a pickup of 23. And it's good enough for a first down. Back to throw. Over the middle, he hits Austin. And down inside the 15 he goes. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains. He's back to throw. His pass caught at the 4. And he gets into the end. So that does it. Put this one in the books. A successful Madden Ultimate Team solo challenge. See you next time.
Mm-hmm.
Set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Didn't work out this time, but there's always next time. Yep. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. They'll look to throw. He's going to float this one deep right side. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Ah, too bad. Can't win them all, though. Come back. Throw. He's got time, and he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Well, unfortunately, unable to achieve the results you're looking for. They'll set up a throw. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Well, unfortunately, not the result that you were looking for, but... side. Now back to throw. He's got time in the pocket. And it drops down incomplete. Not the results you wanted, but the good news, practice makes perfect. They come out five wide. Three of them to the right side. He'll look to throw. And he can't get innings time. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And it's caught. Touchdown. Deshaun, nice job. Congratulations. Defeating the Madden Ultimate Team solo challenge. So the challenge is laid out in front of you. Can you complete it? We're about to find out. Solo challenge, Madden Ultimate Team time. Let's go. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. They're going to look to throw. Finding time. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. A huge play there right off the bat. And even 50 yards. Like that.
The fuck do you think this is?
Back to throw now on first down. He's going to go up top again. And got his man complete. Touchdown. Deshaun Jackson, 35 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. Not a bad way to start it.
And I think that was part of their script, because so many teams script their opening possessions, and whether it's just that possession or even deeper into the half, sometimes it's 15 to 30 plays. That had to be one in there where they call a shot play, go for the big one, and they got it done.
And the hands team for the Raiders able to secure it. Second down now after the pass completion. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And a hit, Charlie. it's incomplete. Third down and four. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. And the Raiders call on a nickel set for third down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. This is caught by Jackson. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. Through the progressions, it worked.
When you have plenty of people who catch the football, you don't always have to go to your primary target, and sometimes that target is actually covered. Nice job coming off of that and getting it to someone who was open.
And the man out of the backfield gets in for the score. And the hands team for the Raiders able to secure it. So an onside kick fail in the first quarter. Not sure I completely see the logic there.
It's not apparent, is it? And speculate a little bit here. They must feel like they need to steal possessions in this game, and maybe they don't match up possession for possession with the opposite team. They've got to steal it and try and gain an advantage, and they try.
Michael Crabtree's gonna go. That's all the way in. Touchdown, Oakland. Michael Crabtree with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Raiders, they're within an extra point of tying this thing up. That's a heck of a start to this one for him here in the first quarter.
Two receiving touchdowns, just getting the game underway, essentially. I mean, there's a long way to go. If I'm on defense, I've got to figure out how to slow this guy down, because when one guy shreds your team, that's demoralizing. Make them spread it around at least. But right now, he's showing no special teams coaches spend a lot of time scheming things up, but this was just a bad return. Now the offense has a long way to go to try to put points on the board.
Now comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. He's got time. Oh, that is going to be a safety. And on that one, the youngster got caught holding the football a little too long in his own end zone.
And Brandon, you know how we always talk about the clock that a quarterback has to have in his head when he's passing the ball? It has to speed up when you're backed up like this, because you know pressure is coming at you. He'll learn. He's just a rookie.
Touchdown, Oakland. Michael Crabtree doing it again with his quickly for six. Oh, this is blocked. But he doesn't get far. They're able to stop him. And after all that, the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
And that one gets blocked. And there's simply nothing simple about trying to execute the PAT. It's some stuff.
No, absolutely not. We saw exhibit A of it right there.
You know, one thing that's going to be happening in the game now, the analytics side is going to get involved about what it takes, what the percentages are in the snow, what it's going to be like in the rain. All those things are going to come into play. You may see people decide to go for two more often if you have inclement weather.
He's going to air one out. Incomplete.
Well, not that we had any questions, but it's obvious his arm does not hurt today, does it? He does not mind slinging it around.
He is firing that pigskin around the yard.
Yeah, putting it deep downfield, taking shots. Unsuccessful there, but I like his moxie.
And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
A good pickup there, 22. On first down, he'll drop to throw. It's caught by Jackson. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Touchdown. Tavon Austin, a 24-yard touchdown. And his guy's now just a two-point conversion away from tying us up.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. And the hands team for the Raiders able to secure it. And now Oakland ready to take the field. Carr now on first down. Wide open receiver complete. Touchdowns. Unbelievable. And the Raiders add six to their lead. Well, these are not going to be easy on a cold, snowy night, but this one is up and through. Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. They come out 5-1, throw it to the right side. They'll come out throwing here on first down. He's going to look deep down the field. And it's caught inside the 30. It's a big play there. 59 yards. Four wide receivers, one tight end. They'll look to throw here. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. It's the rookie from Michigan State, Shalik Calhoun. In there to drop him for his second sack now here tonight. Looking to throw. Over the middle, he hits Austin. And down inside the 15 he goes. He goes for 18 there. The drive will continue. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. This will be caught at about the 6. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Finding time. And he is going to go down. Charles Davis up, Brandon Gordon. it's San Antonio football here to begin quarter number two. And they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Does it for this Madden Ultimate Team Solo Challenge. Yeah. You did it. You defeated it. Congratulations. We'll see you next time.
Mm-hmm.
fucking kidding me? Said from the sycamore on down. Lily.
What is it?
It's Samsung Gear VR.
You put it in there?
Push the play button.
What is this?
Wow.
Turkey with laser vision. Holiday gifting made easy at Best Buy.
The emissions before they're released into the atmosphere. ExxonMobil is a leader in carbon capture. Our team is working to make this technology better, more affordable, so we can reduce emissions around the world. That's what we're working on right now. Energy lives here. Today's game is sponsored by Samsung Pay. Turn your phone into your wallet.
Happy holidays to Mike Pereira and his crew at the bunker in Los Angeles.
Yeah, I know I appreciate all their help during the course of the season. And Mike, again, has had an outstanding year. Has he been wrong yet?
Has he had one?
Mike ever wrong? I don't remember. No. I really don't remember.
And many of his troops in that photo have officiated at the high school and college level. They come in on Sundays, or in this case, Saturdays, keep an eye on every game. You know, I thought Mike could watch 8 or 9 games at once, but it's probably not possible, even for Mike.
Now we know. Now we know why he's correct all the time.
That's right.
Got a lot of elves out there helping.
Fox will start at the 25-yard line. Well, next Sunday, she's inappropriate and in charge. TV's most outrageous new comedy is coming to Fox. Caitlin Olsen is their guardian, but she's no angel. The Mick premieres next Sunday. Game here in New Orleans. James Winston on the last two drives, 9 of 10 since the interception early in the third quarter.
Yeah, and just that one back play you saw, 16 for 21, but that I know he wants that one back. You know, backed up and his
throws
the interception down the sideline.
First down.
Good job. job by Charles Sims on that play. They were in an illegal formation. He got up onto the line to make it a legal formation and then had a nice block to let Mike Evans get free after the catch.
Five catches on six attempts from Winston today. Evans, the most targets in the entire league among any receiver this season. Third down and one. Winston throws, and it's Evans. Nice catch. And Sterling Moore went to try and make the play, and Evans gained six and a first down.
And it's here on third down. I mean, you know where Jameis Winston wants to go, and it's probably a little bit of the frustration by Sterling Moore right there. Is, my gosh, I know they're going there. How can I not stop it?
This set of downs for the Bucs from the Saints 36. Winston throws wide open out of Humphreys. And Humphreys has another Tampa Bay first down for the Saints 24, a 12-yard pickup.
We've been talking about responses all day, and again, time after time, when New Orleans has gone down and got points, Jameis Winston has rallied his offense to come down the field and try and match.
And the Saints have scored there on their last five possessions. Buccaneers looking to answer, as Winston is wrapped up, and down he goes, Cameron Jordan with the Saints sack.
Just felt it a tick too late. But the most important thing is make sure you hold on to that football. Don't lose that football. So he starts to climb. He feels it breaking down on that side. So we have to compliment Kevin Pamphile. He's a left guard. He's been kicked out there as a right tackle, working against one of the tougher defensive ends in the NFL when you talk about run pass rush.
Buccaneers into the backfield, second down and 17. Officials will get together.
Set the play clocks for 10 seconds.
All right, so the officials wanted to make sure the down marker was correct. It is second down and 17. They reset the play clock to 10. Stop.
Good job by the Saints in coverage on this one. Now they're only rushing three defenders. You can see Sheldon Rankins, 98, kind of drops out, playing kind of that spy. He's the one that makes the tackle.
Jameis Winston today.
I'm Thomas, and I quit smoking with Chantix. To think, after 25 years of smoking, I haven't had to pick up a cigarette. It's such a relief. It's a completely amazing feeling.
Along with support, Chantix Varenicline is proven to help people quit smoking.
My urge to smoke just faded off.
Some people had changes in behavior, thinking or mood, hostility, agitation, depressed mood, and suicidal thoughts or actions while taking or after stopping Chantix. Some reported seizures or sleepwalking with Chantix. If you have any of these, stop Chantix and call your doctor right away. Tell your doctor about any history of mental health problems, which could get worse, or of seizures. Don't take Chantix if you've had a serious allergic or skin reaction to it. If you have these, stop Chantix and call your doctor right away, as some could be life-threatening. Tell your doctor if you have heart or blood vessel problems or develop new or worse symptoms. Get medical help right away if you have symptoms of a heart attack or stroke. Decrease alcohol use while taking Chantix. Use caution driving or operating machinery. Most common side effect is nausea.
Quitting changed my life.
Ask your doctor if Chantix is right for you.
He's coming. The guy we answer to.
Your father is one of the most powerful men in life. Why not take advantage of his position?
What have you done?
Everything I do it for the family.
John Smith,
the top target.
I'm not an assassin.
Yeah. Everything will be fine.
Here's something to get stuck on this holiday season. Switch to Cricket Wireless and get the Samsung Galaxy Amp 2 for free. Plus, plans now start at $30 a month. Just a little holiday cheer from the merrier carrier. Cricket Wireless, something to smile about.
Trust what you see. He breaks on that ball before Russell Shepard makes his break on the inside move. So allowing him to play down. There's 31 in your background. Watch him read Jameis Winston's eyes. He's moving right now. And defensive coordinator Dennis Allen has allowed him that freedom to trust his instincts and be that Robert-type guy on the back end.
A couple of times, how would you explain it to the viewers?
It's a person that's at the linebacker level that doesn't really have an assignment, or kind of in the center of the field that doesn't really have a true assignment, and you're allowed to trust and jump on routes. You trust your preparation. It's very effective when teams are an underneath throwing team, or one of your linebackers occasionally gets freed up and doesn't have a true responsibility on a certain defensive set and can trust his instincts, what he sees, and go make a play.
And Byrd made the play, his second interception today. Saints with a 10-point lead and the football midway through the fourth quarter. Saints have scored on their last five possessions. This is Thomas. Made some big plays today. And Michael Thomas picks up the first down to the 35.
How did that guy last in the second round in the draft? I tell you what, he is something else. Big physical guy, tough after the catch. This organization has a knack for finding wide receivers. Whether Brandon Cooks in the first round, Michael Thomas in the second round, you find guys like Willie Steed, bring him in and let him grow and mature.
You think back to a guy like Marcus Costa, a little over a decade ago. It's Thomas again. Thomas, as you alluded to earlier, missed that first game against the Bucs with a foot injury 2 weeks ago. On a big day today, as the Saints go over 400 yards on the day. Drew Brees now at 299, including six receptions by Thomas, now 81. The Saints rookie record is 88. Reggie Bush is also approaching 1,000 yards in his rookie season out of Ohio State. Second down and five, Tim Hightower. Monte David, the tackle. Under 6 minutes to play here in the fourth. As we said, holiday wishes to the guys manning the cameras.
Ooh.
Garrett.